Namaskaram, dear all. Today, different timing in the session, a Sunday morning, and we know the topic is a very, very relevant and a very sensitive topic. It is the growing social realities and concerns. Just a moment. Welcome, Mr. Crusher Dark. Okay, Crusher Dark is Tanush. My God.
Yes, this is the second account.
Yeah, good. No issues. You can listen to, and you can speak also. So the topic is, as I told you, just a moment. Growing social realities and concerns. We all know this topic does not need any explanation on this. So without wasting time, we will start. The first speaker, Pranesh, you're on the way, right? You're still not ready, correct?
Yes, sir, I'm on the way.
No issue. Then we will. Welcome, Dr. Chakravarti, sir. Welcome. I think we'll start then alphabetically. Can we have the first speaker? Giri, you're there. Okay.
Hello.
Giri,
sir,
tell me.
Sir, can I speak at last, sir?
You want to speak at last? No problem. Yeah. No issues. See, the problem is generally speaking at the first. Speaking at the last is never a problem, I thought.
No, sir. Actually, come alphabetically, so I have a small work, sir.
No issues. Okay, you want me to postpone it to the last slot.
Yeah.
No issues. So, can we start with Ms. Aditi P. Madinur? Ms. Aditi from Sri Sharda International School, Koppal. Aditi, I'm pinning you. Over to you.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, everyone. Myself, Aditi Pranesh Madinur. I am from Sri Sharda International School. So, topic is growing social realities and concerns. So, let me begin. What are some of the social problems that exist within a society? A social problem is an issue within the society which makes it difficult for people to achieve their full potential, and there are some like highlighted points here. Main things are poverty, unemployment, unequal opportunities, and racism and minorization are some of the example problems, social society problems. So there are substandard housing, employment, discrimination, and child abuse and negligence. So what is social concerns? So let me say, what is social concern? A social concern is an issue, problem, or conflict that is a high priority for a society to solve or prevent. I would like to say five social problems: poverty and homeless, or overpopulation, and immigration of stresses, gender equality, healthcare availability, childhood obesity. And one more thing I would like to mention here, there are 10 most biggest issues throughout the world. And surprisingly thing is, which can be like included in India. So let me say those 10 biggest issues. They are as usual poverty, religious conflicts and war, political polarization, government accountability, and education, food and water, then health in developing nations, credit accesses, discrimination, physical fitness. So these are the 10 major things which applies to other nations, I can say. Because it's like in India, yeah, we agree, it's also in India, but it is don't care from people. It doesn't matter more in our India. So what matters more in our India is first of the foremost things which is really very common, and that is harassment, killing or murdering something for something, for someone or for something. And there will be lots of murders without any reasons. And robbing the house and any banks, it's really very common, we can say in India. And a most surprising thing which I would like to mention here is, sir, I would like to say some very short stories here. I read it in newspaper. A 7 to 8 years old boy, sir, who was addicted to Free Fire games, sir. And his mom said him, "You are addicted to Free Fire. I gave you more phone for more than 1 to 2 hours. That's really very enough for a day. You don't please continue it. You just leave it and concentrate on your studies." She says, and she moves. She snatches the phone and she moves. That boy starts screaming. And he says, "I want phone." She says, "No." And he attempts a suicide, sir. Just 6 to 7 years, boy, sir. See the maturity of his mind. Just for a Free Fire, he has attempted the suicide. He ran away to on a railway track and he slept there, sir. Just
very,
6 to 7 years, boy, who has lived this, sir.
Yeah, that's, I think, very, very disturbing reality. Yeah. Mm.
There are hell of the... This we can say across the newspaper, lots and lots, sir. Day by day, lots and lots of comes, sir. And coming to harassment, it's really a very, very, very common thing in India, sir. And a recent act in Tamil Nadu, I can say, sir, just 5 to 6 years old girl has arrested, sir. Just 5 to 6 year old girl who don't have any knowledge about that.
Yeah.
Sir, could you hear us?
Yeah, yeah, I can hear. We can hear you very clearly. Welcome, Mr. Sojan Jose. Mr. Sojan Jose is from the Department of English, Sri Sharda International School, Koppal. Ms. Varsha Reddy also has just joined. We can hear you very clearly. Acha, you got it in the classroom. Mr. Jose, can you keep the camera maybe in the landscape mode, because we are seeing the entire classroom array in a kind of, portrait mode. Yeah, it's okay, in case... can they hear us? Can your students hear us speaking?
Yes.
I'm talking about Mr. Sojan Jose has joined from his classroom itself, kind of a setup. I think they're all hostlers, right, Aditi? All of them are hostlers?
Yes, sir.
Oh, very nice. Sir. How many of them there, Mr. Sojan, if I can ask you? Mr. Jose? Anyway, Aditi, please continue.
Thank you, sir.
Very nice.
And there are lots of robbery things and banks. These are really common in India. And next, I would like to continue with social issues, concerns or depositions. A social issue is some problem for concern connected to a large issue that affects society in general. Often the social issues brought forward in fiction reflect contemporary concerns in an author's own world. And these sorts of issues are in literature often shows up as a theme and affects the plot and outcome of a story. So what are the characteristics of the social problem? All problems are situations which have injuries and consequences for society. All social problems are deviations from the ideal situation. All social problems have some common basis of origin. All social problems are in social origin. So what are 4 stages of social problems? They are emergence and claims making, then legitimacy and revenge claims making, then and alternative strategies.
Legitimacy of the concept. Yeah, legitimacy. Yeah. No issues. Very well spoken. I think Ms. Aditi, a very good start. She looks very disturbed. You know, she looks very genuine when she talked about that boy who was, you know, addicted to Free Fire game. And that girl who was harassed, or who got harassed, or self-harassed, or whatever it is, she sounded very, very disturbed, understanding the serious outcome of this. If this is not arrested at any level, maybe this will become a very big concern. That's what Miss Aditi is impressing upon. And she nicely spoke about, very nicely, she talked about different problems in different world countries, wherein which she says child obesity and physical fitness. Child obesity and physical fitness is of utmost importance that's a very big problem because people are not bothered. Anybody who's physically fit, where obesity, child obesity is controlled, I think things will fall in place. Very well started, Ms. Aditi. I mean, it's a very good start. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Let me also welcome Ms. Aishwarya Anantharaman, just joined us from Delhi. Aishwarya, I can keep your video on and I will get your turn. We are going alphabetically. Thanks, Ms. Aditi. Okay. I move on to the next speaker. As per, oh my God, after Aditi, it is Aishwarya Anantharaman. And Aishwarya, are you ready to speak or should I skip your turn?
I'll speak a bit later.
Later, wait, yeah. wait for others to speak. Listen. Can we move on to Master Crusher Dark? Crusher Dark? Tanush,
yeah.
I'm pinning you, Tanush.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. As you all know, the topic today is growing social realities and concerns. Eternal quest of human beings to know more, to do more, and in recent times, to have more, have been the important factors behind the transformation of the society in various eras. The change in the society in the last few decades has been phenomenal due to increased industrialization and consumerism. Along with the change in the society comes with side effects. And friends, as far as I understand, we need to talk on these side effects that have become the reality of this world. And the most prominent ones are materialism and virtually connected world. As we all know, today's generation is the most resourceful and most equipped in terms of machines, gadgets, and other materialistic comfort. Today, a click can ensure you food, facilities, and comfort. But in spite of such affluences, and comfort, having huge number of disorders like anxiety, depression, etc. The greed and the endless desires are on full swing. The world of social media has greatly impacted the world of social media has also greatly impacted the social behavior of our generation. Undoubtedly, the social media platform has given a platform to easily express themselves or their views, but it also entails the expectations of instant gratification. The happiness of the young generation today so much depends on the direction and number of thumbs and hearts. People are now friends on the social media platforms and not on playgrounds. Hug from the friends, those personal touches are now vanishing gradually, which is quite dangerous for the people. The question is how to resolve these and other issues. And I think the way to address these issues starts with identifying and realizing the seriousness of this issue by resolving it through psychological and spiritual ways. The days are not that far that not just India, but the entire world will realize that development of materialistic way should always be complemented with the development of spirituality amongst the people of society. This is all I have to say. Thank you.
Wow, Tanush, that's very well spoken. Let me tell you, Tanush, student of Pramayas, he's the junior most speaker till date, right? Tanush, you're in class 7, right?
Eight.
You just moved to class 8 now. A junior most of the speakers, and see, he's giving a remedy. The materialistic world can be handled by psychological and spiritual measures. That's really wonderful. That's really wonderful. You know what we are doing, the daily yoga, the music, the dance commitments, and lectures and talks like this. These are the ones which will, you know, possibly will get us back to the track. Is that what you're wanting to mean, Tanush?
Yes.
Very nice. Very nice. I'm very, very happy that at this young age, you got an awakening that a spiritual way of treating yourselves is the most desirable way to control and check any such untoward happening in the society. Excellent. Excellent start, Tanush. Very nice. And That's really, really wonderful. I got a comment from Srimati Ramya Mohan. She says, yes, sir, I was also thinking on the same lines, spiritual and healing lines, and Master Tanush spoke about it. Very, very encouraging for a young lad speaking on these lines. Can we graduate to Miss Geetika Atti? Geetika is joining from Badmer. Geetika, I'm pinning you. And tell me, is Kyatika there with you? Yeah, she's there along with. Okay, Geetika, over to you, followed by Kyatika.
Yes, sir. Good morning, one and all. I'm Geetika Atti from Badmer, Rajasthan. So today I'll be speaking on the topic social reality and concerns. So on this, in basis of social reality and concerns, we should not forget about pandemic, which we are all facing right now. And so on the basis of this, recently UN General Assembly has been held. So I would like to talk about a few points in which UN General Secretary Antonio Guterres have spoke about. He spoke about the five areas which needed our urgent action. The first is, as usual, pandemic. And he called for the world to mobilize the vaccine production to the 70% of world population by the mid of next year. And of course, the next most important issue is the poverty, which he asked. He called for all the people over the world and the governments to end it by 2030, so that the world would be a poverty-free world and everyone would have their property rights and would have their own home. And as usual, we have the equality for women and girls. The most important is this one, which is the end of war on planet. That is, we should not emit any new. There should not be any new emissions or new coal plants by the year of 2050, which is having an ambitious climate and environment which is helpful for humans as well as the extinct creatures or animals, and helping the developing countries like India to shift to green economy. Green economy is nothing but obtaining social developmental goals without degrading the environment or without changing the climate. They are promoting or supporting developing countries like India to shift to green economy rather than the one which degrades our environment and extends the animals and all. So, and there was a survey in the General Assembly meeting. There was a survey conducted about the teens or in the youth of the nearing their 20s. They were conducted a survey of how they are viewing the pandemic, how they are facing the situation, because the teens or the youth are called as lost generation of COVID pandemic, because they can't experience the friendship bonding which they are ought to do in their college days or the graduation ceremonies, which are most precious and one in a lifetime of memories goes on. Even though we are facing the pandemic, the teens or the youth have positively reacted to that, saying that they are concerning over the nature and they have come to know about the importance of nature and each and every small moment which they were taken for granted. So even though we could say we are faced by harsh reality, we could see the hope in the new generation rather than saying the lost generation of COVID pandemic. We could say the new generation for a new world.
Very nice, very nice. I think that's very rightly put across. Geetika has always got a concern about what is happening today, tomorrow, what's going to happen. And she's got a very right way of saying this. The entire concern is shifted towards one problem of pandemic, because with pandemic having taken upstage, the center stage rather, everything else has become a connected concern along with this. Nicely put across, Geetika. Geetika and Kyatika, students of... Okay, Kyatika, can I request you to continue, please?
Yes. So, yeah, I'm Kyatika, and good morning to everyone. I'm joining from Badmer, Rajasthan. So, I would like to talk about the topic on social realities and concerns. Actually, the evidence-informed decision-making in post-truth world. Given the current concerns around the post-truth politics and fake news, it is worth reminding ourselves that the trend for evidence-informed development expanded considerably over the past three decades. It emerged in the 1990s in the health of as an outgrowth of evidence based on medical practice and can now be found in virtually area of development policy. and practice. And the next thing is about research, partnership and networks. Understanding the connections or lack of them between research knowledge and policy and practice is key to understanding how to make the evidence matter. The links of the deeply opaque at the best time at the rooted in power of Luke's 1974, visible, hidden, and invisible.
Very nice. She talks about the research requirement and the connections with the realities. True, yeah, as what rightly opened by the first speaker, Aditi rightly said, ki, she says, whatever may be specific to the world, it may not be specific to we ourselves because of our own ethos, our own concerns, our own ways of looking at things. And she was much worried about, as far as India concerned, one is growing obesity, then she talked about harassment, and she talked about, you know, berserk robbery activities. You know, people do not have respect for each other's requirement to exist. We should come out of that, you know, age-old system of survival of the fittest. You keep fighting with each other and keep killing each other and, you know, keep reducing the population. See, there are two ways. How do you reduce population? Either you kill each other and reduce the population, or you do not contribute to growth in population. The second factor is slightly utopian, slightly difficult to do it, but that's also there anyway. That's very well cross put, Geetika and Khyatika, the Ati sisters, the third in the line, Ati sisters waiting from Tirupati. I'll just wait. That's wonderfully spoken. Ladies and gentlemen, let me also have the privilege in welcoming again Dr. Chakravarti, Principal Sri Sharda International School, Koppal. Welcome, sir. And see, along with his team, Mr. Sujan Jose, the entire hostel, you know, we got about some 30 of the students sitting there in one room where they are watching all of us through a big screen, I believe. See how, what a...
They are sitting in our auditorium.
Auditorium, oh, that's really wonderful.
LCDs.
That's, they're on LCD. The entire school is watching you guys. I'm really thankful for the innovative idea and for the kind of concern and for the kind of... See the kind of concern he has got on a Sunday morning. He got it arranged for the little ones of the school. Sir, thank you so much. That's a great idea to emulate. And this is what is actually happening in Germany in one of my, you know, classes. The entire community hall, of course, they do music and dance. They sit like this. And this on an academic front, Dr. Chakravarti, is innovative idea. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks. And Mr. Sujan Jose, you're there with them, right? Okay. Could you see the big screen? Did you see the big LCD screen? Where Geetika and Khyatika are seen by the whole world today. No? Thank you so much, sir. Really wonderful. And Miss Aishwarya Anantharaman, as per alphabetical order, tell me if you're ready, I'll pin you or I'll move. Yes, sir, Dr. Chakravarti, sir, you're saying something.
Sir, there are three speakers from our school, sir.
Okay.
Already Aditi has spoken, Varsha, Tejaswini, Netra. These are the speakers who are ready.
That's wonderful, wonderful. I think Pranesh has got a commitment to go, right, Pranesh?
Yes.
Can I have Pranesh pinned?
Yes, sir.
Pranesh, yeah. He's a busy man. He's on his travel to Delhi now. Yeah, Pranesh, over to you, please.
Yesham na vidya na tapo na danam, yanam na silam na guno na dharmaha. Devritya loke bhuvivara bhutaha manushya rupena mrigascharati. I would like to begin with this famous Sanskrit Upashitani, which means that a human without knowledge, respect for elders, charity, wisdom, good conduct, virtues and unaware of his duties is a burden to the earth. He is equal to an animal grazing in the form of a human. So as many were like, you know, telling you many evil things are happening, many bad things are going on. But, you know, I would like to, you know, quote few of good things. For example, even in this Ram Janmabhoomi case, Dr. K.K. Mohammed, one of the famous Indian archaeologists who, despite being a, you know, careless Muslim, he was able to provide justice to his own motherland by saying, whatever is present in ancient times shall be with the ancient times. It cannot be erased or something. You know, with his own deeds, with his own good karma, that, you know, we were all, you know, able to, you know, take out, you know, weed out many evil things who don't wanted the ancient narrative of India to be, you know, kept as it is, that is in the ancient manner itself. So, and yeah, I do agree that certain evil things are there, we can't, you know, remove it. Or for example, despite being given a right to equality under Article 14 of Constitution of India, we people are still, like, you know, especially girls and women, they are pretty much the victims of domestic abuse. You know, around there was a survey which has been released by National Crimes Control Bureau. They say that Gujarat, being one of the flourished states, they amount to the one of the top three states of domestic abuse. So when such bad things happen, you know, it's the work of like-minded people like us and law enforcement agencies that need to weed out these disturbing elements in the society. Similarly, what Yagya sir does is like educating all good things to the people. All in Gujarati they say so vache. So it's similarly like teaching good things to people, teaching make people think about good things. Judicial processes are there, legislative processes are there. Still, we are working out to develop good things into better into best, and in that time we will be able to create a very good and a beautiful world. I thereby conclude by saying a famous Subhashitani from Sanskrit: Akashat patitam toyam yatha gacchati sagaram sarvadeva namaskarah keshavam pratigacchati. Thank you.
Sarvadeva namaskaram. Yeah, the wonderful Subhashitam. Thanks, Pranish. Pranish is a very busy man. He's got a busy schedule. Thanks for joining us. Very nicely spoken. And he says, making others to think the good thing, that itself is a great concern. That concern should perpetuate. I think Pramayas is doing it for pretty long years. We've taken pains and time to see that you, like youngsters, come into the fold. And I'm very thankful to all those youngsters who have joined a great movement where whatever little bit we are doing as a collective effort is showing up results. And see, I'm really impressed the way the entire auditorium of Sharda International School is sitting. The students are sitting and watching the program, and very many of them will possibly take up to talking about this concern, the way it's going as a movement. Really, really wonderful. Thank you so much, Pranesh. You're a busy man. Thanks for being here with us. And let me also tell you, for the girls, children, it's a great news. November 14th, for the first time in the history of UPSC, girls' children are permitted to take UPSC exam for joining NDA. For the first time in 2023, we will see some of our girl children joining NDA. That's a very, very great concern for all of us. It's a fantastic reality today in the existence of NDA for so many decades. For the first time, this great change has happened. And I'm sure all of you are aware of this. That's a wonderful news. Thanks. I'm moving on to the next speaker. Okay, can we have this fire?
Sir, you are muted.
Oh, sorry. Oh, yeah, my mic was off. Yeah, the message was, thanks, Pranesh, for having been here with us. He's a very busy man. And girls' children are going to be joining NDA. November 14th is the date where, for the first time in the history of UPSC, girls' children are permitted to take NDA examination. And in June 23, they'll be joining NDA for the first time. And that's a greatest concern and the reality which has come true. We're all very happy. The parents and principals and mentors of girl children around. That's a great news for all of us. Can we have the next speaker? Miraya Prakash. Miraya, that means all you three will be speaking from the same ID, like the way Geetika and Kyatika has done. Over to Miss Miraya Prakash, children of Brahmayas. They've been regular contributors. Over to you. Okay, the first speaker from the team is going to be Miss Anushka Unni. Anushka, over to you, beta.
Thank you, uncle. So good morning, one all present here. So today we are talking about a very interesting topic: growing social realities and concerns. A social issue is a problem that affects many people within a society. It is a group of common problems in present-day society, and ones that many people strive to solve. It is often the consequence of factors extending beyond an individual's control. Social issues are the source of conflicting opinions on the grounds of what are perceived as morally correct or incorrect, personal life or interpersonal social life decisions. Now, social issues are distinguished from economic issues. However, some issues such as immigration have both social and economic aspects. There are also issues that do not fall into either category, such as warfare. Now, the issue which particularly struck a chord with me was social stratification, which is the differentiation of the members of society based on their occupation and income, wealth and social status, or social and political power. It determines the position of a person within a social group, category, or geographic region. Social stratification refers to a system by which a society ranks categories of people in a hierarchy. It affects life chances, lifestyles, and prestige. It creates emotional stress and depression for the people belonging to the lower stratum, as they have unequal access to wealth, power, and prestige. Now I want to ask, who here objects to caste system? Everyone, I think. Social stratification is very similar to it. So shouldn't we demote it? India, a country's constitution is based on equality for all, is one of the greatest traits of this problem. It has become a growing concern for many, and until the government tries to de-escalate the situation and tries to help people to become more open-minded, nothing can be done. Now I would like to end with a quote by Albert Einstein. The distinctions separating the social classes are false. In the last analysis, they rest on both. Thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful. Greatly spoken, Ms. Anushka. And she rightly said about the social, the perceived inequalities. Yes, yes. She's also wanting the government intervention to totally demote this. Slightly utopian, but yet it's happening in a very big way. For the members to know, for the children to know, way back, maybe 60, 70 years before, commissioning in the defense services was only limited to the royals. We all knew it. Today, if I'm a rickshaw puller's son or an Anganwadi's worker's son or a daughter, nothing stops me in becoming a commissioned officer or even president of India. Abdul Kalam ji, the world, you know, celebrates him as one of the best ever presidents the India and the world had. We all knew the humble backgrounds he started with, what he had as a child, what was there for him as a youngster, how he went through and where he reached. This possibly was not possible maybe 50 years, 60 years before, where certain posts, certain status in the society were reserved only for elites, which is no more so, which is a very big departure what this world has achieved. And yes, what Anushka spoke is very much real. In a big way, it has to be addressed. And I'm sure with the kind of thought and, you know, concern what you've shown, Miss Anushka, things will work out for the benefit of each and everyone in the society. Very well spoken. Thank you so much. Okay, Pranesh, you got something to say? Quickly, I'm pinning you, Pranesh. Pranesh, quickly. Okay, the next speaker. Yeah, Pranesh, okay, thank you. Arushi. Yeah, tell me, Pranesh. Yeah.
Hello. Sir, I just wanted to add a note by saying that I had a conversation with my hostel warden. He was like, with your behaviorism, with your way in which you express your things, and with the, you know, with the calm attitude, you can, you know, eliminate all sorts of elements, evil elements in this society.
Absolutely.
I was like, I am not the only person who wants to remove it. Everybody wants it. But the right place to, you know, tackle is through the school system and the legislative approach that people should adopt. It's not the, just, you know, one-man job or an institutional job, you know, to remove the evil elements.
Very well said. But yeah, a journey of 10,000 miles starts with that one step. And the problem is, who's going to take that one step? It may be Pranesh, it may be Tanush, it may be Anushka, it may be Aishwarya, it may be Miraya. It is already Dr. Chakravarti who's doing a big thing for the school and for the society. Children, please understand, this is a message from me, from Premayas, to the children of Sharada International School, Koppal, who are sitting in the auditorium and watching. Varsha, Aditi, and everyone. The kind of concern what your principal and what your school has got towards you is something really, really amazing. Because there are very few of us who got a time on a Sunday, which is not an official working day for you, but he is, see, he's a very busy man. He's got a very big tight schedule. I'm very, very personally thankful to you, sir, for the kind of concern you have towards your children and towards the entire society. A great applause. And okay, next, Arushi, can I pin you? Over
yes,
to you,
sir.
Arushi, over to you.
Uncle, can you hear me?
Just a moment. Yeah, Arushi, I can hear you. Start, please.
Yes, sir. So nowadays, our society is becoming more and more cynical day by day. Man buys the most expensive of watches, but does not have any time for himself. Has the biggest of houses, but has small families. Donates millions to charities, yet fails to notice people in need in his own surroundings. Our society constantly compromises its base values to make space for the man's addictions. Now, I'm not talking about addictions of social media or alcohol. I refer to the addiction towards money, power, ignorance, luxury, etc. We all have heard several times about cases of corruption, black money, etc. These are the results of when a person falls prey to the allure of these addictions. Next, our society barely has any space to be with everyone's constant judgment at the back of our minds. And nowadays, due to social media, one little mishap of ours can be seen by several people. This has led to cancel culture, which has now become a big problem. Now, cancel culture or call-out culture is a modern form of ostracism in which someone is thrust out of social or professional circles, whether it be online or on social media or in person. It prevents any exchange of opinions or investigation of truth, even when that would involve appropriate or necessary measures. Cancel culture is undeniably toxic, as it involves criminal theft, invasion of privacy, etc. Now, with all these problems that have been normalized by society, comes the rise in the cases of mental incapability, like clinical depression, anxiety, EDs, etc. This has formed a vicious cycle, which in the end affects the human race, and the worst of all it is that these things are so normalized by society that until we look deeply into the matter, nobody tends to label them as harmful. So I would like to conclude by saying, as grows our society, grows our limit and capability. But we must know when to step down and when not to lose ourselves in the matter. Thank you.
Oh, that's very excellent way of putting it across, Ms. Arushi. Arushi spoke very crisp and very, very particular about one thing. He said, do not try to ostracize anyone. Don't try to cancel or call out anyone from the network. She wants inclusiveness in whatever we do. Sail along with, go along with, take them along with. Do not just degrade or do not just remove somebody just because he or she is found to be slightly not aligning with your thoughts. That talks of the huge inclusivity what a society should do, because agar panch unkliyan panch bacche hain, panch bacche barabar nahi hain. If all the five are alike, then there's no why the fingers are different, why thumb is different, why pinky is different, but they have to coexist. This is the kind of inclusivity we need to have in the society. It's very well spoken, Arushi. Concerned thought, very well researched talk. And okay, can I also say for the inclusivity, now all of us will wave at each other and say hi to everyone. Can we everyone say? Open your videos and say hi everyone. Okay, now
hi.
All of us say hi to the children who have joined as observers. See, how many of them are observers from Sharda International School, Koppal? Everyone says hi to Sri Sharda International School, Koppal. Ramya, say hi to everyone. That's
hi.
Really wonderful, wonderful. Such today is one of the very memorable gatherings, I would say. We have new entrants joining. And that's really, really wonderful. Very well spoken. Okay, Miraya, next is your choice. Just a moment, Miraya. Just a moment. Huh? Yeah, over to you, Miraya.
Well, good evening. Good morning, one and all present here. Today, I'd like to speak on social realities and its concerns. Now, many people believe that equality is one of the principles of social justice, when it's not, but it's actually equity. What's the difference, you might ask? Equity is the takes in the amount of the effects of discrimination and aims to an equal outcome. A proper example of this would be, there are three people trying to look over a fence. One of them is already tall and is able to see. This represents the most privileged in society. The other can barely see, and the last person, the most vulnerable of the society, can't see at all. Equality gives one box to each of them to stand on. but even though the tallest person doesn't require one. So, but equity, it doesn't give the privilege any boxes. Instead, the middle person gets one and the last person gets two. Now everybody stands at an equal level. By definition, social equality is the existence of unequal opportunities and rewards for different social positions and statuses within a group or society. And what that means is, if you've ever been interviewing a person and didn't hire them because of their race, religion or anything like that, you have been a part of the problem. Not hiring someone for their race or religion doesn't have anything to do with their ability to do the job. This is one of the biggest social inequalities I can think of. But the social inequality that irks me the most is apartheid or racism. All of you must know about the Black Lives Matter case. For those who don't, a police officer, Derek Chauvin, and his three colleagues arrested George Floyd for suspicions of having paid $2 billion in a store in Minneapolis. They handcuffed him and pinned him to the ground. They put their knee on his neck for nearly 10 minutes, even though the man kept shouting that he couldn't breathe. The indifference of a dying man's groans to the pleas of a constant distraught passerby, he continued to keep his neck. This was the most devastating moment for me, as just because for the reason of having a darker skin color, I'm discriminated against. Even take some of the most popular literatures. For example, everybody must know a classic, To Kill a Mockingbird. It is one of the biggest examples of racial inequality. Most of you might not have noticed, but Kapoor Ninga, the housekeeper for the Finch family household, who was black, was one of the most modest double lives I've ever seen. The idea that she had a separate existence in the outside the household was a novel to one. It had nothing to say nothing having a command of two languages. Also, in the book, it also talks about how the black people had to live in one side of the town where almost no white people went and people were scared to enter. This is a very big, even though people brush it off, oh, this must have happened in ancient times. Did you know that police violence is a leading cause for young men's death in the United States? Over the life course, about 1 in every 1,000 black men can be expected to be killed by policemen. The risk of being killed by police is peaks at the age of 20 to 35 for men and women of all racial and ethnic groups. Black women and men in American Indians and Alaskan Natives, women and men significantly more likely than white women and men to be killed by the police. Now this is a currently declining social reality. But let's take one of the more common ones, poverty. Poverty is a state of condition in which a person in a community lacks financial resource and essential minimum standards of living. Poverty means that the income level for employment is low and the basic human needs can't be met. Poverty-stricken people are without proper housing, clean water, are unavailable to these poor souls. Each nation may have its own threshold that determines how people live in poverty. The impact of poverty on children is substantial. Children who grow up in poverty typically suffer from severe and frequent health problems, while infants born into poverty have increased chance of low birth weight, which can be led to physical and mental disabilities. In some impoverished countries, poverty-stricken infants are 9 times more likely to die, and the infant mortality rate is sky high. These problems are not only for the parents, children. The parents suffer through so much mental trauma just to get each day a proper meal. Now, these two problems are solely based on how people view others. If one was to show kindness to a person in the street and give them at least 100, they could eat meals for over 10 days. Whereas we spend 100 rupees on just stupid snacks such as chips or chocolates. Now, each one of these and racism. It is just incorrect to judge somebody based on their color. It was not something we could decide. So how is it right that we get judged on it? So I hope you understand. And I would like to thank Yagnaravan sir for giving us this great opportunity to give our thoughts with his intellectual mind.
Excellent, excellent, Miraya. Miraya, being a doctor's child, she always speaks from health point of view. And you very, very rightly said. But let me tell you, worldwide, the oppression against apartheid or kind of, you know, treating somebody bad just because having a darker shade of skin. I think this is reducing in a bigger way. And Ramya Mohan from Chennai, she was on support. She says, I think it's on the decline. If you really see the number of cases against, you know, this sort of issues have reduced a lot. So let me assure you, Miraya, maybe when you grow up to our age, you will find this problem is totally wiped off, because I can understand the concern you have towards this. The child mortality rate and treatment towards the oppressed class, just because I wear a different shade of skin, of which I have no control over that. Very well spoken, very, very well thought of. You were very emotive in saying so. I could understand that you were disturbed when you touched about this topic. Very well done. Thank you. Good round of applause. Okay, fine. I move on to the next speaker. Pranati Atti from Tirupati. The Atti sister. Pranati is a regular speaker, a student of Pramayas. Welcome, Pranati.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, everyone. My name is Pranati Atti. The topic I'm going to be talking about today is growing concerns of social realities. So we all know that social realities are all around us. It may be parties, games, political rallies, and even nations. Social reality is the consensus of attitudes, opinions, and beliefs held by members of a group or a society. Humans are immersed both physically and virtually in a universe of ever-changing social realities. They play a major role both in determining how humans live and how well they live. The social realm affects not only how humans relate to one another, but also how they react with the rest of the biological and physical realms. Social reality is something what perspectives. The word social is derived from the Latin word soci, meaning Alice. Social reality is an idea of coming to a certain decision or law in a community, taking the opinions of all the members in the same, but keeping in mind the primary goal of achieving the welfare of the common mass on an equal judgment. Finally, I want to share some realities of society nowadays and what I've experienced in my life. Girls are not allowed to wear clothes according to their wish and comfort. People's widely open eyes makes them very uncomfortable, and that leads to harassment and sexual harassment. Laws are meant only for the good and common people. Big fish have ways to escape from the reach of the law. Just because they have money, they can escape law and other consequences. Animals are not harmful to our earth, but humans have been exploiting nature. We are only adding pollution to the earth. No one wants to take a longer path of hard work. Most only show off, not sure even after clicking the selfie that he would give money to the speaker. I won't elaborate on that because I actually saw a picture on the web, and it talks about how when people are having good heart and they're donating or they're giving something to the poor, they take selfies and they upload it to social networks so everyone can see how good they are. But on the inside, only they know that they're not doing this for their heart, but they're doing it so people can think that they're better. Money reduces the efforts required to reach your goal. For example, when for college, you for people that are very rich and for people that pay money, they can easily get the seat no matter what their results on the exam were. But for poor people, they have to try really, really hard just to get there, but many people don't succeed. Mobile is everything. We eat with it, sleep with it, wake up with it, our life is occupied with it. Some people can't even have sound sleep without their mobile. I've experienced this in my school in America because everyone in school, no matter what the rules are, the rules in our school is no cell phones allowed, but everyone takes up phones, and their excuses are that there will be emergency, so we need to call our parents, which is not the case. But everyone wants their phone so they can have some fun during class. Mobiles and ebooks are digging the grave for books because nowadays people don't want to read paperback books or hardback books because ebooks in mobiles or technology is growing, and everyone wants to read on your computer because it's free and it's easier to access. But in my opinion, reading normal books is much more because it doesn't affect the eyes, and it also really helps us understand the overall situation.
Wonderful, wonderful, Pranati. Pranati has her raising in Canada. She's on a small hiatus at Tirupati because she'll possibly get back to Canada, and she knows the reality out there. It's been 1.5 years. I've been communicating with her through her parents' mobile only. I don't think that she owns a mobile phone for she herself. She is a grown-up child. She's in class 10 now. She doesn't own. Same is with Kathika also. There are very many students, of course, the little ones who communicate with us through the parents' handsets. That's really wonderful because they don't want themselves to waste time on this. And Pranati also talks about equality, and she says today the biggest concern is mobile phones. It robs off your time, robs off your private time, robs off your quality time to interact with others. Even you go to restaurant, you go to schools, colleges, people are busy texting and conversing with each other. Maybe there is a friend of yours sitting at the next table. You're communicating with him or her through your mobile handset, which is very, very incorrect, she says. Very well spoken, Pranati. Thank you so much. And we move on to the next speaker. Next speaker I have is Miss Prisha Jude. Miss Prisha Jude is from A4 School, Coimbatore. Prisha, over to you.
Good morning, sir. Good morning to one and all. I am Prisha Jude of Class 11 Air Force School, and I am here to give a presentation on social realities and concerns. Social problems represent conditions that should not be allowed to continue because they are perceived to be problems for society, requiring society to react to them and find remedies. Public issues or social problems demand a public response. Now let us discuss a few common social concerns I am sure everyone is aware about. Poverty, unemployment and overpopulation. These three are deeply entrenched and intertwined with other social concerns. About 9.2% of the world or 689 million people live in extreme poverty on less than $1.90 a month according to the World Bank. Poverty is the root cause of other social concerns and evils. Poverty is not natural, it is man-made. There are various causes of poverty, but the most important is overpopulation. Rising population is putting the burden on resources and the budget of countries. Governments are finding it difficult to provide food, shelter and employment to the rising population. A poor person is not able to take proper food and nutrition, and his capacity to work reduces. Malnutrition is another social concern that is prevalent in most third world countries today. Reduced capacity to work further reduces his income, making him poorer. Children from poor families never get proper education or schooling. They have to work to support their family, and this destroys their childhood. Some of them may also be involved in crimes like theft, murder, robbery. How can you get out of the cycle of poverty? The answer is you can't, not at least not easily. When you're living from paycheck to paycheck, there is no savings because most of your income is being spent on basic needs like food, shelter, clothing, transportation. Also, because of poverty, women and children are forced into prostitution. It is unfortunate to say that child trafficking, child prostitution and sex trafficking is still common today. Another cause of social concern is racism and terrorism, because of which we have witnessed the loss of many people's lives. We are also deeply grappled with the ongoing climatic changes which is affecting the well-being of everybody on this planet. Recent examples of global warming are seen in USA, Canada, Europe and Australia. I'm sure everyone has heard of the Australian wildfires. It is the need of the hour to quickly address the destructive effects of climatic changes. I would like to conclude by saying all of the above mentioned are a stark reality which has been affecting people all around the globe. Just because some of the above mentioned concerns do not apply to us, it applies to so many people who pass in the backgrounds of our lives. The fact that people actually go through this makes this topic even more dark and real. In order to curtail the ongoing effects, we as a society need to put an end to the driving forces which lead to these social concerns. This can only be achieved by cumulative effort, will and resilience. Thank you.
Fantastic, fantastic, Ms. Prisha Jude. She spoke mainly about two concerns, and she says for everything, the root cause is poverty, which is not natural, which is very much man-made. I'm totally with you. It's because of inequal understanding of the social requirements of the youth, each other on a humanitarian basis. She says every problem stems from poverty, which is not natural. That's a very, very nice way of putting it across. And she says we cannot do away totally with poverty not being around here, but we can take actions to minimize it in the maximum possible way by having concerns for each other to happily coexist. And she also spoke about very nicely about the climatic change and concerns. Very nicely put across, Ms. Prisha. Very, very, you are very emotive, very, you spoke from the core of your heart addressing these issues. And I'm sure the years to come, this thing will take shape. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, to Ms. Prisha Jude joining from AFO School, Coimbatore. And I move on to the next speaker, Ms. Shivani Rajesh, again from AFO School, Coimbatore, a regular speaker. Shivani, over to you.
Yes, sir. A very good morning to one and all present here. My name is Shivani and I'm from class 11A from AFO School, Coimbatore. The topic is realities and concerns. Now, my words would throw light upon one of the important sections of this topic, which is existing evil and brutal social practices in India. As you all would be knowing, India is no stranger to strange rituals. Being maimed, burned, killed in the name of religion is not history. Over the centuries, numerous communities have combined their rituals and traditions to form all kinds of odd mixtures, unique rituals and festivals out of nowhere. Because of this, the apparent progressive world we live in still practices some horrific brutal rituals, which in spite of being banned by the government, see a large number of participants even today, of which I'm going to fill in a few of these now. Every Dashera, devotees from Andhra and Karnataka gather at Devragatta temple to hit each other on the heads at midnight with lathis. Drenched in blood, these men go on with the celebration till the break of dawn to commemorate the killing of a demon by Lord Shiva. This Bani festival has been celebrated for over 100 years. Now what is shocking at this is that earlier axes and spears were used instead of lathis. The ritual of tossing infants from a height of 50 feet and catching them in a sheath held by men. Now what is it? Has been practiced in Maharashtra for over 700 years for the prosperity and good luck of the family. In some places, people are even marrying their toddlers to a dog to ward off so-called bad omens. Faith is a precious ray of light that pulls us out of our inner darkness. The same faith at some times takes on frightening proportions. Following a 48-day fast, many devotees pierce their bodies with hooks and skewers called veil, and may even try pulling tractors or other heavy objects with these hooks in their skin. Others pier their tongue and cheek to impede speech and thereby attain full concentration on the Lord. Now moving on from Indian customs to the caste system in India. Casteism has been one of India's oldest problems. While society has changed, many still hold on it. The Kuke Subramanya temple has a strange centuries old tradition called spit bath. Those from lower castes roll on floor over food leftovers of Brahmins on banana leaves to rid themselves of various ailments. Many say, who talks about caste in the 21st century? Nobody has time for it. But one day, we will experience how caste-based discrimination is still alive and prevalent in our society. If not publicly, at least in subtle forms. The caste system in India not only dictates one's occupation, but also dietary habits and interaction with members of other castes as well. Now coming on to a funnily interesting one. Any guesses? Obviously superstitions. Now superstition is a kind of blind belief in supernatural powers that don't have any acceptable or scientific explanations behind them. Superstitions in India are a serious problem. Though it is hard to believe, it is true that some pundits or fake babas are still spreading superstitions in India in the name of religion. The half-literate people believe superstitions easily. India is a land of weird and unsettling traditions. In some parts, people still believe that crossing of the road by a cat in front of a vehicle is inauspicious. If there is an itching in the right palm, there is a possibility of some gain on that day. If a crow starts to caw on the house roof, people expect the arrival of the guest. Even some superstitious people have classified the 7 days of the week in a different category. They believe that Tuesday and Saturday are not auspicious days to start a new job. On the other hand, Thursday is the best day to do so. Isn't it funny? People fall in the grip of superstitions due to a lack of education. Thus, the literacy rate of the country needs to be improved to remove all superstitions from India. Otherwise, superstition will reduce the speed of development of a country. That's all I have to say. Thank you.
That's really wonderful put across, Ms. Shivani Rajesh. Shivani always has been a very, very... Shivani, keep your video on. You're still on. Keep your video on. The people are watching you, your reactions to what you spoke. And she spoke very, very much against about, you know, okay, Sri Lakshmi is sitting with Shivani, the same ID. That's a good thing. Now she says the caste-based, the rituals and the practices which she finds no scientific reasons to continue. She also spoke very much against about the superstitions, and she says, how is it justified at all? She reminded me of one age-old saying. It goes like this: Val neenda karunguruvi valamirunde idam sendral kalnadayai ponavarum kanagadandi eruvare. It's very, very superstitious. It's very akin to a black cat cutting across your way, and you're not going to achieve the task of the day, something like this. But certain superstitions were, you know, allowed in the society just because it sounded positive. Just because they said, okay, you got somebody crossing, do not cross his pathway. But you got a somebody specific crossing, take a blessing from him. It is again based on the caste supremacy, which she, you know, really, really chided upon. She says these three aspects are not going to help the society in growing in a particular manner, which we really deserve. And she nicely started with a statement: strange situations are not strange to India at all. Yes, a country which started with a belief in ethos and moral values, which were built upon the case studies over the years. It's been about some 6,000, 7,000 odd years of civilization which existed here. It'll take time for us to come out of those superstitious values, even the spit bath, what in Kukke Subramania temple, that entire village does it. She's done a lot of research, a lot of topical research into giving us facts and figures. A wonderful talk, Ms. Shivani. You've always been known to speak with facts and figures. A round of applause. Thank you. And we move on to the next speaker from the same ID.
Sir, can I go on next?
Oh, Aishwarya, yeah. Your turn was number one. Okay, Sri Lakshmi, just about 2 minutes.
After
Sri Lakshmi. Okay. Sri Lakshmi, it is your turn now. Next will be Aishwarya. Okay. I'm pinning you, Sri Lakshmi. Where are you? Just a moment. Shivani Rajesh's ID. Just a moment. Huh? Oh, she just got disconnected, I believe. She's out. Okay, Aishwarya, you continue. Okay, let me tell Miss Aishwarya Anantharaman is the latest add-on to Pramayas. She's going to be doing Bharatanatyam, vocal music, and also German language. She's a budding lawyer. Joining us from Delhi, and over to you, Aishwarya Anantharaman.
Yeah, good morning to one and all present here. I'm Aishwarya Anantharaman. I'm pursuing my PLLP honours from Bangalore. I'll be starting my course recently. Today, I'm not prepared that much as the other students have, but I would like to keep my viewpoint on this issue. Social problems are basically, I believe, they're divided into two levels. That is, one is individual level, that we all face, that some face that others do not. For example, addiction towards something, or suicide, or juvenile delinquency. But on the other level, that is the collective level, that is the society as a whole faces. For example, poverty or exploitation or any kind of discrimination, or for that matter, population explosion, which is quite a huge issue that comes up recently, and these days it's quite prevalent. Now, I would like to talk about the concern about COVID. About COVID, that is the pandemic, that the pandemic has taught us. Things that it has taught us, that is, the main thing is to be close to our family, that is our loved ones. Respect them, respect our elders, give love to our young ones. And also to help others at their tough times. And also to give them love, that is, to help others is the biggest thing in the world that we can do. One thing is, one quote that I would like to say is, there is no exercise better for the heart than reaching down and lifting people up. So this is a famous saying that is helping others during tough times. That personally, I have experienced this. That is, one of my members was hit with COVID in recently November last year. So I had my own mother during Diwali that too. So I was quite shocked that day. Many people have come across this time, that is the fear of losing their loved ones to COVID. So I was one of them. But you need to keep your strength going on, that is willpower, mainly building your willpower and mental health. Mental health, which is very prevalent, is mental health, which has gained the prevalence due to COVID, I would say. That is keeping your heart healthy and your mind as well. Keeping your mind healthy is very important so that you give strength and love to others as well and help others in their tough times. So I would like to end it by saying that our main purpose in life is to help others by the Dalai Lama. Thank you.
Wow, Aishwarya, you made us proud. And she says the message is love your dear ones and support them in the tough times. And as Geetika started, she's the one who touched about the pandemic issue and rightly connected by Aishwarya, things do not look or work the same way in different perspective during different times. She says, respect each other, give love and support to your near and dear ones, because that is the most important thing which is needed at tough times. Because the same, like they say, every day is not Sunday, but every situation is not the same. Very well spoken, Aishwarya, very passionate.
Yeah,
Chaluma.
I would like to say one more thing.
Just a moment. Somebody's mic is on. I'm trying to mute it.
Yeah.
Okay, over to you. Uh-huh.
Yeah. I would like to say that no family is perfect. We argue, we fight, we even stop talking to each other at times when we get annoyed. But in the end, family is family. So the love will always be there.
Kya baat hai?
So love.
So wonderful. I mean, just about a young age of 19, she's speaking so matured and so, you know, futuristic. Really, really wonderful, Aishwarya. We are, you know, you made us proud the first time.
It is.
See, that is what Tanush spoke the same thing. Tanush talked about a spiritual healing, which Ramya supported. She said, yes, sir, what he speaks is absolutely right. It's a young age. So is with you. You're a young girl who spoke in a very, very matured platform. We are very proud of you. I think, yes, love and support and, you know, a kind gesture towards each other is the required thing of the day, which is the biggest concern.
During the pandemic, this is the main thing that we should take care. This is the main concern, I think.
Absolutely, absolutely. So wonderful. A round of applause. Over to now Sri Lakshmi Chemmala. Sri Lakshmi, I'm pinning you. Yeah, please continue.
Yes, sir. Good morning to everybody. I'm Sri Lakshmi and I'm here to talk about social realities and concerns. What's happening to our world? Crime, violence, suicidal tendencies, even among children. Like coronavirus, a global pandemic. Okay, now if I say, oh, I'm worried about my exams, that's positive stress, that's useless. But if I say, I don't have that expensive materialistic life that my friends have got, now that is distress, the unwanted, the negative stress. Now, well, to be precise, I think the topmost social concern that must be fixed at first is a person's individual's mental health, because we as an individual consider society. We consider society. So individual mental health is required for a social view. Many of us are not ready to accept the social reality as it is, because we sometimes tend, we are comfortable. We always want to be in a social reality where we are comfortable, where we are safe. We do not want to accept reality. If you ask me, I would say do not accept reality as it is. Now sometimes they say, my life rests in my hands. No, it is not, because 50% of your life is not under your control. But the rest 50%, you desire it, you choose, you respond how you want your life to be. Now that 50% rests in your hands. Example, somebody you love just passed away, just died. So you will feel ruled out, but you decide what to do next, how to move on. Like, life moves on, but you decide how it does. You decide how it moves on. we sometimes face a really bad time, and we are in a really bad time. We tend to think, oh, reality is bad, people are bad, I am bad, I had a day through the storm, so hence my reality is bad. Now, that is a very negative perception of how you view reality, because it's okay if you're having a bad day. Just wake up early, just find your own peace, say good things to yourself, respond to chaos and circumstances in a very peaceful manner, like a power plant. It does not have energy of its own. It generates and transforms energy. So be open to good changes. Just do your duty and be passionate. Like they say in Malayalam, Bhogathinai kundu kamikyam menda, Bhogam maya kridam varjikyam menda. What it means is, don't wish for luxuries, but at the same time, don't forget the luxuries that you've got. Don't pick up logs and you've got diamonds. If you focus on the hurt, you will continue to suffer. If you focus on the lesson, you will continue to grow. So, thank you. And hence, you decide, because your mental health, you must decide how your life must be.
That's really, really wonderful. Bhogam mayakritam varjikim vanda. She says, don't eschew it. Accept the reality, and she says mental health is the most desirable one, which will translate to every other positivity. And very nicely spoken, she says, don't ever be under the cloud that everything is under your control. Things may go out of your hand, but you should be like a basketball which rebounds. A basketball thrown on the board, you get it back, again you have a chance to aim and shoot the basket again, right? Is that what you meant, Sri Lakshmi? Very well spoken, very, very different perspective, because everyone is under utopian thought that I have the controls, I have everything. Unless you fly an aeroplane which behaves to your controls, nothing is under your control. In Air Force parlance, people say, I have the controls, means between if Shivani and Sri Lakshmi are flying a helicopter. Now when Shivani takes over the controls, she announces it. She says, I have the controls, means Sri Lakshmi will not fiddle around with the controls of the aeroplane. It happens only in a mechanical world like an aeroplane. It doesn't happen in the exterior or the real world where things do not happen to your control many a time. She says, if a day starts bad, so what? Smile it out. Fine. Don't ever think that everything is under your control. This is a very, very positive way of putting it across. Accepting the human limitations, connecting it with the mental happiness and mental health. Very well researched and spoken, Ms. Sri Lakshmi Chemmala. And she says, do not eschew the worldly pleasures. If it comes to you, accept it gracefully, right? Very well spoken. Okay, I move on to the next speaker. We have, just a moment. Srinidhi Ramachandran, again from the same school. Sir, in the meanwhile, can I request Dr. Chakravarti, sir, with your permission, why not we nominate one speaker just for 1 minute, one boy and a girl from the audience, but they will speak in Kannada. Is it okay? We don't want them to speak in English, because we would like to listen to the native way of speaking, the language of Kannada, language of Malayalam, language of Telugu, Hindi. Every language has got its own beauty to speak about. If it is okay, can we require each from Sharda School auditorium, but essentially they'll speak in Kannada. The same topic, if it is okay for you, sir. Just a food for thought. Over to Srinidhi Ramachandran. Srinidhi Ramachandran, again a very, very passionate speaker. She is joining from Air Force School, Coimbatore. Srinidhi has put in Jammanur Vividhi Vachin Manduta. It's so nice to see there's one boy from Koppal always. He's very happy posing as, no, Shashank, I think Shashank. His religious science. Why not? So happy to see you, Srinidhi. We are blessed to see your bright appearance today. Over to you.
Good morning to all my present here. I'm Srinathi Ramachandran from Apostle Coimbatore, studying 11th grade. So let's move on to today's topic. So when I talk about social reality in psychological terms, can be explained by an example. In a class, when a teacher explains a certain topic by the method of questioning and interacting, both the teacher and the student reach an understanding. It's more like a weighing scale balancing, and both the quantities understand each other is a social reality. Or when do we get concerned about a situation? We get concerned about a situation when we can't control it, happening without our concern, or when we acknowledge a neglected fact, or when things are far gone and out of our hands. As Albert Einstein said, one of our social predicted one of the social reality. He feared the day technology will surpass human interaction, and it has now. When I went to Google and searched Pirouette, the results were based on viral love and the particular things Google knew about my interest. The next day, I was startled to find my suggestion pins of ballerinas on Pinterest. When I connected the dots together, I had a moment of epiphany. I realized the apps that were designed to connect humans together could be weaponized, as data of an individual is the most valuable asset on earth. With the data of an individual, I can easily predict or determine an individual's decisions. Facebook discovered they were able to affect real-world behavior and emotions without ever triggering users' awareness. Cambridge Analytica, a political consulting firm in the United States, worked for the Trump and the Brexit campaign, dealt with 5,000 data points of every American voter in the year 2016. It targeted those whose minds they could change until they saw the sponsored or the recommended world they wanted them to. Truth will out, and it did when some workers did realize the targeting tools and information warfare was a targeted was a weapon. This can be compared to a movie ticket you bought but ended up being the main protagonist acting without just watching, or a Wikipedia page that shows customized results or customized definitions for each one of us. Treacherous, isn't it? The fact that all of us as individuals have put ourselves in a position where a group of engineers somewhere miles away from us can manipulate our human psychology in a way to benefit them, can control our emotions, makes me sick. We have a whole new world of people who are more depressed, anxious, more than ever, and this was totally designed by humans is unbelievable. Fake news spreads 6 times faster than true news. My mood, my energy, my ideas, my plans can be manipulated and determined, leaves me with an unsettling feeling. Data rights are human rights. It is beyond my belief that we don't have a term to acknowledge this. This is a threat to every democracy in the world, and we must pass laws. So the next time you pick up your phone, remember the apps that are designed to make you stay longer, tricks you into doing something good as well as bad. And if this leaves you with an unsettling feeling, delete your history as a first step you can take towards fixing this problem, and wonder how blessed you use your gadgets. The population of the earth and the country has become a major concern. Population increases when birth rate is higher than the death rate. As the population grows, the resources offered by a particular space drain. Each and every person living leaves behind a carbon footprint as well as traces of pollution, and becomes a catalyst to climate change, which depletes the resource that can be offered in the upcoming years to the upcoming generation. 100,000 marine animals die yearly from getting entangled in plastic. The fact that 50% of our plastic is single use, and this is just the reported statistics, assures us that we all have blood in our hands. As we have spoken in our earlier group discussion, education has now become a commercial business, and that lies inequality, and now in pandemic, it is now more than ever. We now as a society mostly recognize the consent of an individual to be a better adult, to make better decisions. We understand the importance of mental health of a person as it affects our day-to-day activities. We acknowledge it, and in most cases, it is just as important as kidney stones, and there's nothing to be ashamed of it. We have seen wars, battles raised just because we couldn't be a better, compassionate person. It disgusts me to see the impact one group of humans, terrorists, gangsters, can leave on a spectrum of people, causing long-lasting trauma and loss that can never be compensated. In Tamil, we say, we say that. And we as a part of the 21st century are now more significantly aware of the outer world thanks to technology helping us connect all over the world. But it is important to be able to make significant decisions, take actions to make this world a better place. The government can pass bills and laws, but it's one's consciousness that should drive us towards a change that we aspire to see. We learn and we continue to learn from the past, because we couldn't have been here today without one. And if comes a day where conflict between technology and humankind arises, humankind will definitely win. Without a humanity, we are not truly ourselves. And if we think that a problem or a situation does not concern us, and it just concerns a particular group of people, and I think we are a part of the problem. And because every problem related to a group of community or a or an individual is a problem of us, and it's a problem of the humankind. So, thank you.
That's very, very, very fearful and a very passionate speaking by Shriniti. Ede inillada or speech nu solala namba, because she has connected so many dots and nicely put it. Let me tell you, she's the one girl way back she spoke, I still very fondly remember. She says, my mom is there around to see every time what I do is right or wrong, and she was very happy in flaunting it. She says, ki I have no problem in my mom checking me things, and it's very, very unlikely for a child of today's age, a class 11, grade 11 girl child, telling her, I'm very happy to say that my mom is there around for each and everything I do. She's very friendly with me. She's checking on me. She says, beta, what you do is right or wrong. And she was very happily flaunting it. Means, let me tell you, way back, say 30, 40 years before, her husband helping a wife in washing the clothes or doing the daily chores or washing, you know, utensils, bartan, was considered and looked down upon. People never felt very comfortable in saying it. Today, you will find a gentleman doing, you know, go to the clothes line and help the wife or the girl child to dry the clothes or to help do the household chores, which is considered the cool thing. And he tries to tell the world, look, I'm helping my wife. Look, I'm helping my girl child or so. What was considered to be a male ego or a pride 30 years today, people don't think it as a cool thing anymore. They think he's a stupid. Why he is not helping his wife or child? He should do it. If he doesn't do it, he's called as a male chauvinist. If he's not helping, he's a kind of a bad guy. What was considered the wrong thing 30 years back, today is the in thing. I'm very happy. I'm telling you time and again, in my entire career, having been an academician or whatever it is, the first ever child who was proud to tell the world, look, I'm being controlled by my mom for the right reasons, and I'm very happy of it. I think this is one silver line where every child of today should pick it up and say, there is my father, there is my mother, there is my older sister who's behind me seeing everything to tell me whether I do is right or wrong. Because today's world, with the way how things have moved technologically, I don't know what I do is right or wrong on a social media. There is somebody above me, there is somebody who's an expert in this, having handled it. Say, beta, what you do is wrong. This is not what is being done, and I'm happily accepting it. Thank you, Srinidhi. Very, very well. You made us proud again. I move on to the next speaker. See the round of applause you're getting, sir. There. Sir, okay, yeah. Dr. Chakravarti, sir. Something, sir, with you.
Sir, for the time being, actually, the two children are there right now, ready to speak.
Yeah, we will go with them. No problem. We will move on to your auditorium, sir. Yes. Over to Mr. Sujan Jose. Yeah. I am pinning Sujan Jose. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Who's the one, sir? You want to speak?
Netra.
Yeah, Miss Netra. Please speak. Miss Netra from the audience in Canada, right?
No. She speaks in English.
English. Miss Netra, over to you.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, I can. We can hear you.
Yeah, I can.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Netra. I'm from grade 9.
Mr. Sujan?
Just one second.
Mr. Sujan, can you please mute your LCD screen speaker? The voice is rebounding. Yeah, Ms. Netra, please continue.
Child obesity, also called pediatric obesity. Child obesity is a complex health issue. It occurs when a child is well above the normal or health. For all year, age and height, the process of excessive weight in a young people are similar to those are in adults. Also influenced by parents' community. It affects the ability to make health choices. Now I'm going to speak about gender inequality. Gender inequality is a social process by which men and women are not treated inequally. The treatment may arise from distinction regarding biology, physical, or cultures, norms. Prevalent in the society, some of these distinctions are empirically grounded with others appears to be social constructed. Thank you, sir.
That's wonderful, Miss Netra, and she spoke with all her classmates and friends around her in the auditorium. It's a very, very innovative way of interacting with us. Now, that's very nice of Dr. Chakravarti, the principal, and Mr. Sujan Jose, the one who's coordinating the event from there. It's wonderful. See the kind of technological advancements. See the kind of interest the school had taken in seeing that it is possible today where one of their schoolmates is speaking and everyone is watching or listening. Miss Netra, very nice. You spoke about the social inequalities and you want to have a positive construct towards it. It's sure to happen. Sir, anybody else in the audience? A round of applause. Varsha. Varsha will speak. Ananya, did I see you? Is Ananya there in the audience?
Yes, sir. She's there.
Oh, Ananya. Oh, she's a regular speaker and she's one of the star speakers there. Ananya, a word from you. Anything you want to say? Quickly? No.
Tejaswini
will speak. Okay. Tejaswini, over to you. Tejaswini, where are you? Miss Tejaswini?
She's there.
Okay.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, we can.
This is Tejaswini from Kisharda International School. I'm going to say my views on social realities and concerns. The practice of dowry is one of the worst social practices that has affected our culture. In independent India, one of the landmark legislations is the passing of the Dowry Prohibition Act in 1961 by the government of India. Despite the fact of the practice of both giving as well as accepting dowry is banned by the law and such acts are punishable offenses. The system is so truly embedded in our culture that it continues untouched. It is a social or rural or urban area, the violation of the law is rampant. Not only dowry deaths, even most of the acts of domestic violence against women, including psychological as well as physical torture, are related to matters of dowry. Some of the very basic human rights of women are violated almost every day. Sometimes it is heartening to see someone girl stand firm to assert rights against dowry. But there is an urgent need to strengthen civil, social, economic, political, and administrative measures in order to free India's society of this disease. Thank you.
Wow, Tejaswini spoke in particular about dowry as the biggest problem in India. Yeah, which cannot be ruled out in Indian parlance. Yes, oh, that's a wonderful LCD screen I can see. Tejaswini, what you spoke is very, very true. And yes, measures are in place. And I'm very sure very soon this evil will be out of our society. Very thoughtful of you, very nicely spoken. Thank you so much. Sir, any more speaker from Koppal?
Varsha Reddy.
Ms. Varsha, over to you. See, as we rightly said, from the same ID, any number of children logging in, we will allow them to speak in continuation. Just to know, save on time. Okay, Ms. Varsha, over to you.
Good morning, everyone. Today, I'm going to speak about the
Varsha, one second. Mr. Sojan, can you mute your mic there? Only the mic. Varsha, please continue.
Sir, you have muted me.
Varsha, please continue. I have muted my mic.
Social reality is distinct from biological reality or an individual cognitive reality representing its at it does a phenomenological level creative through social interaction and thereby transcending into general motives and actions. Reality is not an objective thing that is imposed upon us, but it is created by us. Reality does not exist externally, but internally as each individual or group interprets it and is always changing. Social realities are all around us. They are worthy focusing on. They are all made up of entities in a sense. People just sort of decide that these things are going to exist, and so they do exist. They have a huge impact on our lives. Social realities are a creation of human mind. Human mind expectation influence social reality and may contribute to social problems such as prejudice and inequality. The influence of expectations on social reality generally is more limited than often they claim. One of the most important limitations on the contribution of expectations to the social problems may be that they are often accurate. Example, they predict others' behaviors and attributes without influencing those others' behaviors and attributes. Social realities can dictate how we view the world around us and in turn influence other choices and decisions. The major social issues or problems nowadays majorly are parasites, homicides that majorly come in criminal activities. These type of criminal activities are observed more in the countries like USA and New Zealand, but they are growing in small scale in our countries also in between these 20 years. But the major thing that is affecting the Indian social reality is the influence of Western culture on Indian society. India is a secular country where the people have the freedom to practice any religion and also to convert to another religion of their choice. So all the cultures are freely accepted and are respected by the Indians, but the influence of Western culture started in India during the 19th century when the British established their colony in the country. Western culture, considered as the most advanced culture on the globe, has started summarizing its flavor on Indian youth. The major impact of Western culture on Indian society was there were different kinds of westernization on one kind to emergence of a westernized subcultural pattern through a minority sections of India who first came in contact with the Indian Western culture. This includes the subculture of Indian intellectuals who not only adopted me cognitive patterns or way of thinking like these styles, but also supported its expectation. The poorly mobile and untouchable caste adopted the lifestyle implant in westernization. This was facilitated by the prevalence of various non-Sanskritic traditions, among them such as eating meat and drinking alcohol. Indian culture, which is one of the world's richest culture in the world, with very language, custom, belief, ideas, practice, instruction, work of art, architecture, ritual, ceremony, accepted Indian culture, history of service, the strong thread of beauty and importance in the relative culture. Today we are adopting the Western culture. But actually, the main thing that is adopted by our Indian people or population is eating meat and drinking alcohol. Actually, it has affected the whole population and it has disturbed the Indian population. So this shows that we are actually affected more on the Western culture. When we were in British time, because of their force, we used to follow their Western culture. But after getting freedom, we are not knowing, but still we are following their culture. This shows that we still haven't came out of their freedom. So, thank you.
That's very, very wonderful way of putting it across, Ms. Varsha. She says the reality exists, but it is more internal than external. Is that what you wanted to say? And she rightly says, why should we continue to follow the colonial way of living, our lifestyle once we have come out of the shackles of that. I think it's very nicely spoken, Ms. Varsha. We are running short of time. I'll have one more speaker and finally I'll request Dr. Chakravarti for a wind up. Giri Teja, over to you. Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause to Ms. Varsha Reddy. Very, very thoughtful of her. Giri, over to you. I'm pinning you.
Yes, sir. Good morning to you all. Sorry, sir. I can't. I know it is disturbing. Sir, it is a cyclonic situation here, sir. It has been raining from yesterday. So that's why I can't.
No issue. Okay, fine. Thanks for being here with us. We will have you the next time. Can I request while thanking?
No, sir. I can speak, sir.
You're speaking. Sir, okay, yeah. Please speak. Yeah. Okay. I thought you're.
That's right. Basically, sir, before starting the topic, social realities and social concerns, first of all, I want to appreciate all the young speakers, sir, because the topic is very mature topic and very crucial topic in this time. But after listening to all the young speakers, it's been inspiring us. We should think like them. Every person has their personal concerns, personal social realities which they have faced in their life. And I have seen and I have listened from these speakers. So even I have also my same concerns. Also, my main concern is about education, sir, because I am in that field. I have been watching from past 3 years because I am working in that field, sir. So basically, before starting the topic, I want to focus on the two words. One is empathy and sympathy. In our world, sympathy overrules the empathy. Once upon a time, if there is an accident occurred on the road, people used to take the patient directly from that place to hospital. But nowadays, before taking the patient to the hospital, people are making videos and photos and forwarding WhatsApp. So, there is no sympathy and empathy exists in that place. Even if we, everybody thinks that social reality and social concerns are only about people, but we should concern about the living beings who are around us, which we call as environment. One speaker mentioned about that. Environment, because without environment, we cannot live. Like without trees, we cannot live. Without animals also, we cannot live because they are helping us like dogs. We are including them in our security purpose also. So, as I'm from defense background in SSB, the officer like the quality has been observed, sir. I want to mention the factor 2 in officer qualities, social adjustment, which is related to our heart. Mainly in officer like qualities, in social adjustment, in SSB they observed about 3 qualities. One is social adaptability, cooperation, and sense of responsibility. As we all know that social adaptability and cooperation, everybody knows, but I want to focus on the point sense of responsibility, sir. Because many people, even parents, teachers, guide us, but until when we feel responsible, we cannot change the situation around us and around the world also, sir. Like I want to say real life example, not only we can see Chakravarti sir, who has been inspired me from school times. Even after the when we conducting these sessions, sir started this observers. So I bought the so I bring my students to, as observers. But today it is a really great initiative that he put as a large LCD screen. And so this is what is sense of responsibility, sir. We have been conducting these group discussions from all these days. But we can see how responsible sir is, which inspired me very a lot, sir. If there is a chance for me to conduct to join like this, definitely I will do like this. And one many people many speakers spoke about many social concerns. So first I want to all these social concerns and realities can be eradicated through education. Why I'm saying education is that in our country, illiteracy and poverty are playing a vital role in dragging our country backwards. Basically, everybody thinks that education is only about subjects. But recently, in new education policy, we can see that skilling plays a vital role for development of the personality development. Even these sessions, sir has been naming it as a personality development. When personality development happens, automatically social realities and concerns will be eradicated, sir. even crimes also. Crime, if we see the crime rate recently, we have I've seen a statistics, sir. Crimes are happening at the slum areas where illiteracy is playing, illiteracy is more. So basically in this pandemic, everybody has social concerns and social realities, sir. But they put out them only when it is a pandemic or when it is a cycle, like this disastrous situations only. In pandemic situation, we have seen many, literally, I'm working with an NGO, sir. So in normal days, whenever we ask for a donation or whenever we ask them to donate to the poor people or orphanages, very few people come forward, sir. But in this pandemic situation, it's a large donating has been happening. And we also, one speaker mentioned about the government. So if we take the government also, government has come forward to give free vaccination, free medication in our Andhra Pradesh government is giving free treatment, medical treatment for COVID in Aarogya Sri, which is a scheme here. So the government is also playing, but as I say, that sense of responsibility. Until we support them, they cannot support us also, sir. Government, how much is there is a limitations government to support the people, but people do not understand this. So at the final, I want to say my personal experience with Ignoraman sir and Chakravarti sir from my school days, because it is related to this topic, sir. I think I was in 6th class or 7th class, Ignoraman sir was posted as a registrar, sir, in our school. The first, I still remember that day, sir. Until that, I have not drink or eat in others' plate or others from others' glass, sir. And the first day of your joining, the first meeting of yours with us, you make us to sit on the road outside the Annapurna mess, and you have given one glass to each other, and in that water, I think water or milk was there in the glass. He had told all of us to drink half of the glass, and other half you should exchange the glasses with others. So which shows all these people in the which I want to mention this point, because some few speakers spoke about racism. That shows how we can eradicate racism. This very point can eradicate. This means in school we all are same. Nobody is different from others. And also, sir, Srimati spoken about their parents. Yeah, parents are way. We should be concerned about. We should focus on this point, sir, because parents are the main root to develop these social realities and also, and after coming to some age, teachers also plays a vital role building these social realities, sir. I want to give an example of this Chakravarti sir who came. Sir, when I was in science school, my birthday is in Makar Sankranti, sir, on Makar Sankranti, which leaves are not being given to us. But it is a great, it is a big festival here in South. So, sir is to celebrate my birthday in their home. So which makes me feel that I am in home. Even today, I remember this day, sir, because even when I was weak in mathematics, sir, and Chakravarti sir was my mathematics teacher in class 11th and class 12th, he took a great interest, and even he used to wake up till 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock at the night and teach me in the house, sir.
Wow.
So which makes me which make my mind that yes, whenever even when I am in teaching field, so I think that we should join with our students so that we can understand what the problems are with this and how they are thinking, what are the main and also in our soft skills, sir, we call these social realities as interpersonal skills, sir. How we react with the social surrounding us, these all are interpersonal skills, and these can be developed by SWOT analysis. SWOT means.
Thank you, Giri. We are running short of time. We have done 1 hour and 40 minutes almost. It's long to come. Thank you so much, because you have so many things churning up in your mind. so wonderful. Maybe Chakravarti sir, one of these days we'll have a talk show, yes, you know, by Giri himself. he can hold the audience for 2 hours.
Yes.
Thank you
yes.
so much. I think we have done with the last speaker. While thanking Dr. Chakravarti for a wonderful initiative, see the way how he has garnered his resources to make the entire observers available at one place in an auditorium through a big screen with a speaker, with a camera and all that. It's so worth emulating. Very soon, Pramayas would be happy to conduct an inter-house competition for the Sharda School, where we are already discussing the modalities. That's so wonderful. And Dr. Chakravarti has been with us from day one in all the events, and he never misses any such event. Heartfelt thanks to you, sir. And can I request you to wind up the talk of the day with your expert words as a principal?
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. And congratulations all the children, all the participants who spoke really well on the topic. Very apt. They touched upon so many social events and social realities and the ways and means to address those realities. After all, the topic is very wide. There is no limitation for this. Social realities are they are good realities, they are few unwanted realities. Definitely we need to address unwanted things, and few things, a few incidents I suddenly remembered and I want to bring it to the notice of all the participants. Few years back, there was a gathering of all high school children in one of the posh resort in Hyderabad. That is a gathering of not one single school, all hi-fi schools, like they are children of very rich people. It was a Facebook friend gathering, and there was a murder of one girl child on some issues of these high school children. That was shock. Actually, it happened in 2017, and it shocked the educational circles. And later on, the people investigated and they found the culprit. It is because of too much of liberty given to the children and non-observance of parents on children's activities. And few lacunae we could find out in the system. Next week, in Rayan International School, in a washroom, one small boy was murdered, and the school was given holiday. And the reason they found was it was by some 11th standard child to postpone his examinations. See, these are realities. The children are considered to be, next to God. They are being spoiled by various mediums which are all around. This is what we have to observe and what we need to correct. Let it be social media, let it be... there are so many people who have to play their role aptly. Schools, parents, elders. As elders, we all have that responsibility. And at the same time, as Rangarajan said it rightly, through proper legislation and education, only these realities can be addressed. And individually, we can change ourselves. But in society level, if you want to change, definitely a higher authority, higher powerful agency should work towards that. This kind of discussion definitely bring thoughts. And we have started thinking on that. It is a beginning. Definitely, all good things will, let us hope that all good things will prevail and all evil realities will slowly get addressed and they get their backseat in our society. We can't avoid 100%, but definitely we can take it forward in the positive note. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Really, really wonderful, because you've seen both the sides. You've handled the children as an educator from the grassroots level. Now you're operating from an higher echelon with a higher and an increased level of responsibilities. It's very, very nice listening to, you know, young ones, and the way you summed it up, the way you're spearheading the cause and for the requirements of the society in the best possible way to ignite the young minds. I'm very thankful that, you know, the way how our endeavors are being supported by all the, you know, principals, parents and students alike with a lot of interest. Let me also tell you, we take interest in carrying out various other modules. You know, we do musical programs, yoga, academic events, talk shows, and I would certainly request the stakeholders to be part of such things, because we have very less time for each other in the society. Like rightly he said, empathizing and sympathizing, where sympathy takes the prior role than empathizing with others. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks for being here with us, and on a Sunday morning, it is really wonderful. Yes. But yeah, maybe the next talk show, we will limit it for about 3-4 minutes per speaker. Yes. We can't, you know, today we just took a chance being Sunday. Yes. Otherwise, we have the day left with other commitments also. Thank you so much, sir. And Mr. Sujan Jose, a wonderful way of monitoring and making things out there. Can we have on the screen? Can you come in front of the camera, sir? Mr. Sujan Jose? Are you there?
He is there.
Yeah, he's there. That's what I thought. Yeah, thank you so much, Mr. Sojan. And your principal is sitting in the control room. You're sitting in the auditorium. What a wonderful way. And I think today the hero of the day is Sri Sharada International School, Koppal. Thank you so much. And thank everyone. We'll meet thank next you. Week with another topic. Jai Hind.
Thank you.
Jai Hind. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.